So the other day I was looking at Adobe Premiere on a Mac when I noticed it had three rendering settings instead of just the two that my Windows machine had. I was expecting the Mercury Playback Engine GPU acceleration with OpenCL option because it had an AMD graphics card in it. But what I wasn't expecting was the GPU acceleration metal option. This led me to the inevitable question of, which should I use? I did some online looking and wasn't able to find the answer, so I decided to test it out myself. First, a little background for the uninitiated in hardware acceleration rendering. When you want to publish a video, you first need to set it to render to the format you want. Usually this is H.264 for web publishing because it's a small size and high quality. Computers take all the edits you've done, apply any effects such as stabilization, filters, or lighting changes, and then combine them all into an output of your selected format. Some of these video effects can be done faster on the graphics card due to its streamlined nature compared to just using the normal CPU. In order for the software, in this case Adobe Media Encoder, to use the graphics card, it must use an Application Program Interface, or API. This generally comes in two flavors, CUDA, supported by Nvidia cards, or OpenCL, which is used by AMD cards and Intel integrated graphics. However, starting in 2014, a third option became available for Apple-based products called Metal. Metal essentially does the same thing as CUDA and OpenCL, but is created by Apple. It is convenient because it provides a similar API for iPhones, iPads, Macs, and Apple TVs. So, which should you choose when rendering using Adobe products on a Mac? Well, for my test, I made a 5-minute test video by combining 5 separate videos, each using a different codec. 2 of these were shot in 1080p, and the other 3 were shot in 4K. One was also at a different frame rate. I then applied an effect to each video, some that were GPU accelerated, and some that were not. Specifically, the GPU accelerated effects were fast blur, invert, and warp stabilizer. The non-accelerated effects were channel blur, lighting effects, and just for fun, I reversed one of the videos to make it run backwards. The point was, I wanted to simulate a mixed workload that wouldn't favor one rendering method in particular. I selected the default YouTube 1080p HD setting for my output. I ran the 3 tests using OpenCL, Metal, and software only, which doesn't use the GPU acceleration at all. I performed the test with all other programs turned off. For the hardware, I chose the absolute top-end 27-inch iMac model that Apple makes, which comes with a 4 GHz quad-core Intel i7-6700K Skylake processor, 32 GB DDR3 SD RAM, 1 TB of flash storage, and an AMD Radeon R9 M395X graphics card with 4 GB of video memory. I also ran the tests on a mid-2015 15-inch MacBook Pro with more modest specs. It has a 2.2 GHz quad-core Intel i7 Haswell processor, 16 GB DDR3L onboard memory, 256 GB of PCIe-based flash storage, and it was using the integrated Intel Iris 5200 Pro graphics with 1,536 megabytes of VRAM. This way, we can see the effects of Metal on both a dedicated AMD card and Intel integrated graphics. I was pretty surprised by the results. I was expecting OpenCL and Metal to be close, which they are not. I definitely wasn't prepared for Metal to actually take longer on the iMac than the CPU only. The MacBook Pro scales nicer with the Intel graphics. What this says to me is that Apple and Adobe still have a lot of work to do on the Metal API, and that I recommend using the OpenCL option in Adobe. This shouldn't be too surprising though, because OpenCL has been around for 5 years longer than Metal. While this video was intended just to test OpenCL versus Metal, I couldn't leave it there. I wanted to know how my Windows computer compared to the top-end iMac. What differences would I see between a $1,600 PC and a $4,000 iMac? Well, for starters, my Windows PC has a 6700K 4 GHz Intel i7 Skylake processor, That's the same one that's in the iMac. 32 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM. Again, the same amount that's in the iMac. The fact that it is DDR4 doesn't matter, as shown by the Linus Tech Tips video I have linked in the description below. It has a Samsung 850 EVO 500GB SSD, which is slower than the iMac. And finally, it has an Nvidia GTX 1080 Founders Edition graphics card with 8GB of GDDR5X VRAM. Now, before I hear you complain that these graphics cards aren't comparable because one is much newer, just remember that this is the highest graphics card available on an iMac. So, running the same test using CUDA acceleration and then software only, here are the results compared to the OpenCL results for the Macs. It's no surprise to see that the Nvidia GPU took the cake, it being a more powerful card. But what I wanted to point out here is how much faster the CPU was on a Windows machine. Not only was it almost the same speed as the CUDA accelerated times, but it was nearly 30 minutes faster than the exact same CPU on the iMac. Why the discrepancy between the PC and the Mac? Well, the iMac has a much smaller enclosure and can't effectively cool its components as well as a tower PC. When it gets too hot, such as when rendering video files, it has to thermal throttle the CPU down to a slower speed so that it doesn't overheat. This means you're not always getting all of those gigahertz you paid top dollar for. A well-ventilated tower PC doesn't have this problem, and the CPU can run at full speed the entire time. To bring this all together, currently, if you want to use Adobe to edit and process videos on a Mac, make sure you set it to render with OpenCL GPU acceleration turned on. And I'm not knocking Macs because they do have a lot of great features, but if you're trying to decide what to spend your money on for a video editing workstation, you could save yourself nearly $2,000 on a high-end Windows PC and 4K monitor over an iMac and see better performance to boot. Thanks for watching. If you found this video interesting, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you think I missed something or want to see a different test, tell me in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and after you've done all that, check out one of our other videos up here. I'll see you next time.